for coming. It's great to have you here.
Yeah, no.
Always happy to be here.
I saw you on Saturday night.
We did. We saw each other at a birthday party on Saturday.
We were at Ellen DeGeneres' birthday party.
60th birthday party.
Which was a lot of fun. And I was standing near the door.
Uh-huh.
And you walk in with your friend, Jason.
Yep.
And the guy I was talking to goes, oh, my God, some hunters just walked in. Because you were dressed like a Filson catalog.
Basically.
Like you were very outdoorsy.
It was because we rode our motorcycles over to the party.
So you had to keep warm.
You had to keep warm, keep safe. So, you know, I was like denim on, I mean, don't make denim boots, but leather and a hat.
If they made denim boots, you would have been wearing them.
I would have been wearing denim boots if they hadn't made them.
It seemed as if you two had showed up to beat everyone up at the party.
Which would have been pretty impressive given the people that were there.
Well,
it would have been horrible.
You'd be in prison forever for your whole
life.
Forever. Yeah. But it was a good look. And now you're wearing Mickey Mouse, I see.
I am.
Our corporate overlord.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I grew up in Orange County, so I grew up going to Disneyland all the time. And I just woke up, I was like, I don't want to roll with Mickey today.
What are some of your fondest memories of Disneyland as a child?
Man, growing up in Disneyland, I mean, it was one of those places that you'd go and you'd fall in love, but you'd also, like, go and get in, like, real trouble.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, I want to hear about both of those things, but start with the trouble.
The trouble? When I was 12, I was there for my birthday, and I was allowed to take two friends, and I think it was Aaron Steger and Jeremy Rex. And one of them had the good idea while we were on the SkyTram, which is this cable that runs over Tomorrowland and
connects
a bunch of
those. It's not there anymore,
right? It's not there anymore, probably for this very reason. When we were on the car ahead of my mom and dad and my sisters, and as we were going, one of my friends, I don't know who it was, had the great idea to play a game called spit on someone and try and hit someone.
Right, yeah. When you're 12, never stop spitting.
Totally.
It's a weird thing.
It's a glandular thing, maybe.
Yeah.
So, you know, we're spitting over the edge and like, oh, wow, I hit a ball, dude. And, oh, yeah, I did this. and we think, and be like 20 feet before you finish, you're like, oh, they're watching now. So just be cool. And then all of a sudden, we get there and the guy at the end of the ride is like, excuse me, can you guys wait right here? Where are your parents? I go, oh, they're in the one right behind us. And like, just wait right here. And they're just staring at me.
Uh-huh.
And then my mom and dad get out. And my dad, they're like, excuse me, sir, is this? Yeah, it's my son. It's his birthday. Oh, cool. And my dad walks over far enough out of earshot away, and then he walks back, and, like, birthday was over.
Oh, is that right?
It was, like, it was done. It was done. Like,
We
went home.
Wow.
That was it. Yeah.
No spitting at Disneyland.
No spitting at Disneyland.
Did you learn anything from that experience? Do you feel like it taught you anything?
There's cameras everywhere. That's what I feel like I learned. There's cameras everywhere.
Thanks for watching, and remember, every time you click the subscribe button, one of your enemies gets destroyed.